Here we are, back into the pool, back into the aqua jogging belt. All right, first of all, thank you so much for all the comments on yesterday's vlog about the 100,000 subscribers. I'm reading all the comments, taking your ideas, writing them down on paper. Once I'm healthy, we're gonna start putting them into practice. And second point, yes, we're gonna dive into running injuries and the lessons that I learned through this training block, what maybe went wrong, share those with you so you can hopefully avoid those mistakes that I made in the previous 4 months, basically. Tomorrow, when you're watching this, I might be at the doctor's office, so that's kind of exciting, going to the podiatrist today, Thursday. Stay tuned for updates. All right, let's go. Yeah, not too shabby, man. Oh man, just a lot, just aqua jogging. Boom, 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 all day long, all day long. I'm excited to maybe do, I don't know, maybe like a 2 to 3 hour aqua jog session all out at some point, just to see what it feels like, because you can get your heart rate up, but you really, you gotta dig in there. You gotta dig, it's just obviously totally different than running on the ground. So all right, let's head home and get into the studio to discuss these injuries, and figure out what we can do to prevent them moving forward. All right, come on now. All right, there we go. Here we are, lessons, keyword is lessons. We're back in the studio, and yes, we're gonna talk about preventing running injuries. 3 lessons that I have learned, maybe even a bonus lesson that I have learned from this training block. Oh, I'm excited. I'm excited to talk to you about this because I hope it helps some of you out there that are shooting for longer distance races, anything over, really anything over half marathon especially, but it actually, some of the points do apply to shorter distance racing as well. Shorter in the sense of a 5K versus a marathon or ultra marathon. Oh, and here we go. Lesson number 1. The transition from trails to roads. I kinda didn't acknowledge enough how much different road racing and road training is versus trails. And in retrospect, I think I should have been putting a little more time in on dirt surfaces or even grass surfaces, frankly. For example, for interval work on a nice big grass soccer field. So, ultra running last year, and now an easy answer for a lesson learned from this training block would be volume of running. But I don't think it was my volume. Why? Because over the last 4 to 5 years, I have been training at 80 to 100 miles a week. I even went over 100 miles once last year. So I don't think the volume was quite the issue in this training block, meaning how many miles, how many kilometers am I running on a weekly or monthly basis. So I averaged, I was probably in the 80 to 95 miles per week range for a little bit. We'll get into that in a second. But last year I was on dirt all the time at the same amount of volume. So I don't think it was volume. I think it was the fat. One of the lesson number one, I forgot how drastic of a transition it is to go from a lot of trail running to a decent amount of road running. Now, I didn't do all my training on the roads, as you saw over the past 3 to 4 months, but I definitely did a lot more than last year. So I gotta remember that, and that's something for all of you out there to think about. If you're transitioning from the trails back to the roads, watch out, just be careful and make sure you're really on top of your body, like listening to your body and making sure it's not yelling at you too much. And if you're vice versa, if you're transitioning from the roads to the trails, I think a couple injuries to keep an eye on would be rolling your ankles, of course, but more so runner's knee. I've seen quite a few runners who transition to the trails who have to deal with basically a lot more downhill running on steep sections that can really aggravate somebody's runner's knees. And just a couple more observations on this trail to road transition. First of all, I don't know, like I know Jim Walmsley, he's already got the Olympic trials qualifier, and then Sage Cannaday is trying to get it. He still hasn't gotten it yet. But as far as ultra runners transitioning to marathon attempts, I don't quite know too many others outside of Jim, Sage, and I guess myself. I wouldn't be surprised if Hayden Hawks out of Utah, he just has some brute speed. I wouldn't be surprised if he tries to get the Olympic trials qualifier, and I'm calling it now. He's out of Utah. I think he lives in Logan, Utah, or somewhere near there. So anyway, that's one point. And then another point is Kara Goucher is, you know, former Olympian. She's transitioning to the trails right now. So, and she encountered a mountain lion, I think it was last week or 2 weeks ago, out on the trails near Boulder, I believe. So that's a little scary. But anyway, she's making that transition from marathon running to trail running, and I bet at some point ultra running. So anyway, okay, that's lesson number one, trails to pavement, just be aware. Lesson number two, and these lessons, again, I'm mulling over and thinking and reflecting over the past 2 to 3 weeks on the stationary bike and in the pool when I'm just there aqua jogging all day long, and I'm just like thinking about the world. So that's where these lessons are coming from, just so you know. Okay, lesson number two is this training block was too long in retrospect. Listen, I took 2 weeks off at Christmas. I'm proud of that. I always take 2 weeks off, just a complete reset. I love it. It's just like lets the body completely reset. But I started running January 1st. So January 1st to the Cleveland Marathon was 20 weeks. Is too long. But I did take a down week after my first race. Remember, I did a race up in Aspen. It was supposed to happen. It didn't happen because of avalanche danger. But again, I think my sweet spot will be 16 weeks. Now, some elite marathon runners on the guys like Scott Fobel, on the guy side, I believe for Boston, I think he had an 18-week buildup for Boston. So I wonder what Kipchoge does for his buildup as far as, I'd just be curious to see. But I think for me, looking back, I'm going to be shooting probably more so for that 14 to 16 week window. So again, lesson number two, shorten up the training block for me. I think 14 to 16 weeks will be the sweet spot moving forward. And for you, it might be 12. It might probably not 10. It could be 10 though. 12 I think is a fairly standard, but I think for me, I'm probably going to shoot for that 14 to 16. We shall see. What are you going to do? What are you going to do? And the third lesson from this training block for preventing injuries in the future, intensity of pace. And that's kind of an easy answer. I knew I was training at a fast pace. Again, I haven't run this fast in 10 years. All right, sub 5:30, let's say. Like, I haven't trained at this type of pace in 10 years. So I knew, again, going from ultra running to marathon running, that I needed, at 218, 219 marathon, I knew I needed to work on turnover and threshold work. I don't think I missed it too far off. I think I should have been more on dirt, and I think that the threshold runs probably should have been a little shorter, okay? Those are kind of my takeaways with the intensity. Go find some dirt instead of going to Washington Park. And I bring up this third lesson because in college, when I had so many stress fractures, I could usually handle the volume of running, but when we started mixing in track workouts on a harder Mondo track in spikes, that's usually when injuries started to pop up for me. So, gotta remember that moving forward. Just figure out softer surfaces, maybe slightly shorter when it comes to threshold or interval work, and just rely a little bit more on my endurance. You know, I don't quite know what else to do with respect to preventing injuries in the future for myself. And again, you might be able to handle high intensity workouts. I am gonna figure it out. You know I am, but I just gotta keep working on it. Keep working on it. Keep trying, honing in on what works for my body and especially this left foot. And speaking of the left foot, bonus lesson, honing in. I've gotta hone in on this left foot and paying attention to it. And maybe, honestly, I'm thinking about hiring, like getting into a physical therapist on a regular basis, and almost like a strength coach for lower leg work, especially my feet. All right, shout out to all the doctors, physical therapists out there watching this vlog on a regular basis. Do you have any tips for me for everything? I know everything is connected, but I haven't really had injuries above the ankle in years. It's been plantar fasciitis, And now this stress reaction. So I was doing foot exercises all winter long, but I don't think I did enough. I think I need massage, physical therapy, whatever it takes to make sure the foot is really happy. Both feet, but especially my left, but both feet moving forward. So again, all the medical professionals out there, if you have any tips or advice for me, please let me know down in the comments, or maybe shoot me an email, whatever you think is best. I'm all ears at this point. And again, when money is a little more readily available for the family, I'd love to get to a physical therapist once a week, maybe twice a month. I don't know what it's gonna take. Oh, help me out, help me out. I'm ready if you're ready. All right, there you have it. Those are my three lessons and a bonus lesson. Basically, that bonus lesson is more like, let's prevent things in the future. Let's prevent injuries in the future by taking action now on some things. So with the question of the day, I don't want to dwell too much on injuries. You know what I mean? I think sometimes like through this vlog, yeah. Anyway, I just don't want to dwell too much on my injuries nor your injuries. Keeping it positive, thinking to the future, even though many of you I know are suffering through injuries right now, stay strong. You're gonna get through it. It's a game of patience and positivity. And like I said, taking the steps right now to come up with a game plan for how to prevent injuries in the future. Therefore, question of the day: where are you from in the world? I don't want to talk about injuries. I want to talk about, and I ask this question of the day maybe two or three times a year as this global YouTube running family continues to grow. Where are you from in the world? Let us know down in the comments. I'd love to hear. Oh my gosh, it blows my mind. And speaking of where you are from in the world, if you would like to connect with a lot of the people commenting down below on a regular basis, many of us are connected on Demor Global Running on Strava, where we can give each other kudos, comment on each other's posts. If you have questions about injuries or shoes or what have you, you can post there on Demor Global Running on Strava. The link is down below. That'd be awesome. I'm learning a lot about how you guys train, where you like to train, what kind of training runs you like to do. And I can't always comment, but I like to give as many kudos out every day as possible. So anyway, down below, that is it. We're getting through. We're getting through one day at a time. It's like, patience. So when you're watching this, I might be at the doctor's office, the podiatrist. So we will give you an update tomorrow on how the foot is progressing. Seek beauty, work hard, and love each other. We got it. We got this. We got this. Oh, and guess what? I have an update on merch very soon. It's getting exciting. See you tomorrow.